Hello, I'm Justin with Liquid Web. Microsoft SQL Server is a relational database management system created by Microsoft. In this tutorial, we are going to walk through how to install MS SQL Server on CentOS 7 and Ubuntu 16.04. Before we start, it's important to be sure your server has at minimum 2 gigabytes of memory. Additionally, I'm logged into each of these servers as the root user, and you should be as well. We'll start with CentOS. First, let's get our packages updated. Yum update-y. Once that's finished, run this curl command to add the MS SQL preview repo. Now that Yum knows where to look for it, install the MS SQL server package. Yum install-y MS SQL-server. Next, we need to run the configuration script. Enter the command /opt/msql/bin/msql-conf/setup. MS SQL Server is not open source, unlike MySQL and PostgreSQL. In light of this fact, we have to choose an edition. I'll be choosing Developer or Choice 2 because it's free. The next prompt is to accept the license terms, enter yes, and hit enter. Now we are being prompted to create a password for the SQL Server System Administrator. Enter the password of your choosing, hit enter, then do the same again to confirm it. The MS SQL Server service should be running now. To confirm this, run the command systemctl status msql-server. Now that MS SQL Server is running, we need a way to interact with it. Start by adding the Microsoft Red Hat repository. Next, install the command line tools with this command, yum install-y msql-tools unix odbc-devl. You'll be prompted a couple of times to accept the license terms. In order to make it easier to ensure we can execute SQL commands from anywhere on the server, run these commands. Now to verify we can connect to SQL Server locally, run sqlcmd-s localhost-U-S-A. Enter the password you set up during the configuration step. You should notice your command prompt changes to the number 1 followed by an angle bracket. That's it. You now have a functioning MS SQL Server install on your CentOS 7 server. Next up, Ubuntu 16.04. First, let's update packages. apt-get update-y. After that, we need to add the GPG keys for the MS SQL Server Ubuntu 2019 preview repo. Now that the GPG keys are in place, we need to actually add the repo. The package repo we just added requires an HTTPS connection. In order to make sure it's possible for apt to connect over HTTPS, run this command, apt-get install-y apt-transport-https. Now, we need to update apt so it's aware of the repo we just added by running apt-get update-y. Now let's install MS SQL Server. apt-get install-y MS SQL-server. Time for configuration. This step will be almost identical to the process for CentOS 7. Run the command /opt/msql/bin/msql-conf/setup. I'm going to enter 2 for the edition, yes to accept the license terms, and the SQL Server admin password. Now that it's configured, let's verify it's running by running this command, systemctl status msql-server-no-pager. Just like with CentOS 7, we now need a way to interact with MS SQL Server. First, we need to add the GPG keys for the repo that contains the MS SQL Tools package by running this command. After that, we can add the repo with the following curl command. Now that the repo is added, update apt with apt-get-update-y. And install the command line tools with apt-get install-y msql-tools unix odbc-dev. You'll notice some interactive prompts to accept the licenses for these packages, accept them, and move on. After that, we will add MSSQL tools to the path variable so we can execute SQL command commands anywhere on the machine by running these commands. Now it's time to verify that we can connect to MSSQL server locally by running this command, sqlcmd-S localhost-U-S-A. Now enter the password you configured earlier, and again, you should see the prompt change to the number 1 followed by an angle bracket. There you have it! You've now successfully installed MSSQL Server on both CentOS 7 and Ubuntu 16.04. Thanks for watching! For more information, visit our knowledge base at liquidweb.com/kb or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/user/liquidwebinc.